a lot of believers, because I'm speaking about believers now, they ask why the amount of suffering we are going through if we are born again. I want you to look at the situation from another perspective. What if you have someone who is fixated on the negative? They are relief-centered. Let's say they have relief. If things are going well at the job, at least nobody is bothering them, they get a wage at the end of the month, they have their house, they go on holidays, they are married, and the children speak well to them. What's going on there? Such an individual has relief. There are people who are also in the negative, who are upset with some bad traits they have, because those people don't want to look at themselves, they rather look at someone else. But they don't act out and cause trouble with that guy because they don't want any contention. They are relief-centered also. That's why there is contention, but the contention never works out because people want relief. But there's still contention over there. Now, such an individual may see a believer going through all kinds of stuff, and that individual may think, why would I serve the Most High? Why would I serve Christ if I will have to go through all of that? I'm not serving Christ, and look at me. Things are going well with me. What's going on? That individual is deceived. He is lost, or he or she is lost. They have wrong thinking patterns, because remember, they are relief-centered, they're operating in the negative, and the worst part is they're on their way to the lake of fire, so they're lost. But because they are relieved, and the people around have an interest in that relief, people maintain that relief. That's why things go easy with them. But you as a believer, you see, because you have the eyes to see and the ears to hear, and you notice that they are in the negative, yet things are going well with them. It's a deception. It's demons relieving those individuals. Those people who are relief-centered also operate with these demons behind them, maintaining that relief to trap them into the negative, to drag them to the lake of fire with them. So their situation is not to be envied at all. Their situation isn't good at all. It appears good because you look at the external factors. That's why you need to look at the bigger picture. Okay, another thing. If you have hunters, so they want to hunt on, let's say they're hunting on, on rabbits or buffaloes or whatever they're hunting. Which animal are they making more? Which animal are they investing more in? The animal they have caught and that's dying over there, or the animal that is wounded and running away, or crippling away, or creeping away, or whatever you want to call it. Of course, if they have a rabbit over here that is shot and is dying, they have their meal. So they're not going to focus that much on that one. They're going after the rabbit that has been shot, but the rabbit is still moving here and there. See it like that. Those that are lost, why would Satan go after them? He would be crazy to make things difficult onto them, because if things would become difficult onto them, they're going to ask questions. And if they're going to look for questions, big chances to find out the truth. And they're safe. No. Satan's not going after those that are lost. And if you have believers who are not delivered, Satan's not going to make it hard on them. Why? Because they're believers, they carry the name of Christ, but they're in the negative. They are synchronized with the world. So Satan's going to relieve them so that they will trap others in also following the world. Because even though they may call themselves believers, the world notices their walk. And when their walk is in the negative, the world is going to perceive the walk as good because they call themselves Christians. So Satan will promote that. Why would he? I'm saying this. If you are a company and you're dependent upon donations, and you have a group of people, each of them donates 1,000 euros a month to you, are you going to tell them, you know what, you better keep that money to yourself, invest it in your house and your family, because we are scammers. You don't really need to spare that money to us. Of course you're not going to do that. You're a scammer and you depend upon those donations of people who don't know any better. So you're going to invest in your PR to maintain that confident image people have of you, so that you would keep receiving their money. The moment someone doesn't donate anymore, you go after them. Why? Because if he or she doesn't donate anymore and they're still alive, it means that they may have known something. And if they open their mouth, then more people are going to find out. So you're going after the one that stopped donating. You're not going after the ones that are still donating. No, you're going to make them comfortable. The same way, you used to be darkness because you used to be lost, now you're saved. And not only are you saved now, you're also delivered. So you're walking by faith. So you're not donating to the paranormal anymore. You're not emitting that waste energy to feed demons anymore. So what's going on now? Those demons won't receive any funds of you anymore, so they're going after you. Why? Because they're afraid that if people begin to follow your example, they can't operate anymore as the paranormal. That's what's going on. So please, don't look at external factors also. Look at the bigger picture. Well, that's the one I gave to you today. Again, agree with Christ. I'm just a man being used by the Holy Spirit. I'm not the Most High himself. He is the man, so you follow him. That being said, get peace.